Hello and welcome back to the channel. Today, in our continuing FlowJo adventures, we're going to look at some basic steps to perform cleanup on your flow cytometry data. So I have just a basic experiment here, two samples, stained and unstained blood on a 12 color panel. Again, I've previously analyzed these, but just to work through my data cleanup process. So the first thing I would do would be to open the data file and just do a basic forward scatter, side scatter gate so I can get rid of the debris, the clumps, and the really obvious stuff that I don't want to analyze. So something along those lines. Again, I'm not fine tuning into the exact population I want to look at, just a broad gate so I can get rid of the debris, clumps, things I don't need. From there, we could go old school way and do something like a fluorescence versus time. So if we look at our fluorescence versus one of our parameters, say CD3, you can see we had fairly steady fluidics until kind of about this point. You can see it gets a little bit jumpy. There's a few humps, bumps, holes, whatever you want to call them. So classically, you would then just gate on the portion that looked good and analyze that data. However, there are now tools at your disposal that are more fine-tuned, because in this area where our fluidics is maybe not as good, there may still be some good events. And in this area where our fluidics look good, there may actually be some bad events. So to look at this, we're actually going to use a plugin. So there are a few different ones. I generally use Flow AI, there's Flow Clean. I would recommend going back and reading the original research papers to figure out which one is going to work best for you, or test out a few and figure it out that way. So if we open up Flow AI, we're going to go ahead and run that on our population there. All right, so let's take a look at some of these plugins that we can use to analyze and remove these events from our data rather than looking at overtime. So we're going to go into our workspace, our plugins, and run Flow AI. All right, so you can see up here it pulled up what it calls Flow AI good events and Flow AI bad events. So let's open this up and do the same thing we had before. So we will do time versus CD3. And so those are our good events. So we can go ahead and open our layout editor, drag and drop that in there. And you can see it's actually pretty similar to what we pulled out in our time plot. Then if we throw in here our Flow AI bad events, we're going to get basically the second half of our sample looked really terrible. So let's take a look at this other sample just to see what happened on that one. Because normally they're a little bit more mixed in together. It's not quite so cut and dry. So you can see a few blue events, bad events in this red area. All right. So let's open this guy up and do it again. Time versus CD3. Again, these are unstained, so going to be positives. You can see in this one we had good events throughout the entire run, and when we pull up the bad events on top, we have just a few little bad events interspersed throughout. So this is generally what you would see on a sample that ran smoothly. This is what you would see on a sample that generally did not run so smoothly. However, having not run this, you would have analyzed this entire sample and it may have affected your output in the end. Now in my fun FlowJo crash, I lost my original gate. Lesson learned, always save. But it allows me to show you actually another part of my workflow. So what I normally do at this point, because transferring gates between gates that aren't matched can be a little bit of a pain, especially in a big experiment, is go in here and actually export this population. So we're going to export this onto the desktop. And let's see. We're going to name this Flow AI good cells. And we'll we'll go ahead and export that onto our desktop or even just into our existing workspace. Then we'll do the same thing with this guy here. So take our Flow AI good events and export populations. And then this would be our Flow AI. Look at that cells. Export that population as well. All right, create a new group in here. That is our good cells. And we will bring those two populations in. So from here then, we can go ahead and do what we were originally going to do and get our forward scatter, side scatter gate set. So throw that in here. And now we can nicely apply this to the whole group. So both of ours are then gated with our cells gate that is going to, exclude the debris and the clumps. So we've removed bad events, we've removed debris and clumps. Next step is to remove any doublets. So to do that, we're going to open up the cells we are going to work with. And generally people will do forward scatter area versus forward scatter height. So you can see on here, we have our nice population of single cells. And then this cloud down here are our doublets. So we can get a gate that nicely bisects those two populations, bring it up and around and close it off. You may also see people using forward scatter area versus forward scatter width. In this case, the single cells are this population here. Doublets are the one above. So you would gate it in that manner. So again, whichever one you choose to use. So that's data cleanup number three. Removed bad events with a plugin or a time gate. We removed our debris and our clumps. We removed our doublets. So the final step is one that depends on how you set up your experiment, but has something you should have in every single experiment. And that is a viability die, because your dead cells are really have the potential to affect how your stains look. And that can really poorly affect your data. So to do that, we're going to select our fixable viability die. Again, doesn't matter what you put on this axis. We have our live cells, we have our dead cells, and we're going to gate our live cells. And in this way, we can then transfer this whole gating strategy onto both samples and continue on gating our experiment as we would, working with then a really nice, clean data sample. So the basic steps one more time. Number one, remove any bad events where you may have had spurious fluidics. So that's either with the time gate or with a plugin. Again, look to see which plugin is best suited for your needs. Next up, remove debris and big clumps, remove your doublets, and then get rid of your dead cells, and you'll have a nice population to work with. Thank you again for joining us today. If you have any other FlowJo questions you would like tackled, be sure to put that down in the comments below. And don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss my answers. And with that, we'll see you in the next one.